Greeting, my Hebrews like brothers and sisters. This is A.L.D. Smith, the Watchman on the Wall. Grab that King James. We have a real thinker tonight. All we ask you to do is just read along with us and think about what we're talking about, okay? We're going to be dealing with Yah. Yah means of operation, or his M.O. Yah does not change. He does the same thing over and over, all right? He doesn't change. He's not red today and blue tomorrow. He's always red, all right? Okay, that's just an illustration. Now, let's go to the book of Malachi. We always use the regular King James because, like I said in previous conversation, that those TV evangelists, they change the writing, you know, in their Bibles and whatnot. So let us go to Malachi 3:6. And it says in Malachi 3:6, it says, "For I, the Lord, I change not. Therefore, ye sons of Jacob are not consumed." Now, notice it says, "I change not. I change not." Okay? Now, we're going to focus on that tonight. Let us remember, God never changed. Yah never changes. All right? Okay, now let's go to another scripture. Let's go to Numbers, the book of Numbers. Let us go there. Numbers 23:19. 23:19. Look what it says. It says, "God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent." All right. Now, he says also, he says, "Hath he said and shall not do it? Or has he spoken and shall he not make it good?" Whatever he's saying here is whatever he says, baby, it's going to come true. All right. So you can bank on that. So let us focus on that, okay? Let us think about that as we go through our reading tonight, okay? All right. Now, that being said, let us move to the book of 1 Kings. 1 Kings here. Let us go to 1 Kings. Very familiar story here in 1 Kings, but we want you to understand that Yah changed not, okay? Yah changed not, okay? 1 Kings 18. Now, we're dealing with here Elijah the prophet, all right? We're just going to bounce around on some scriptures and then hit the main point that we want to talk about. Let us begin with out of chapter 18, verses 19 and 20 and 21, okay? Let us start there. It says, "Now therefore," verse 19, it says, "Now therefore, send and gather me all Israel unto Mount Carmel, the prophets of Baal, 450. And the prophets of the groves, 400, which eat at Jezebel's table." All right, now, what's going to happen here is it's going to be a showdown between Elijah and the prophets of Baal. Now, remember what I said, God does not change, okay? Now, this is past tense. This already taking place. So, what has to transpire is this same act has to transpire again in the future, all right? That being said, because we know there in the book of Malachi, Yah said that he's going to send Elijah back again. All right, but now I'm getting a little ahead of myself. But I want you to know that Elijah is coming back. All right. Now that being said, let us move here on down here to verses 20, 21. We're going to read on down. Verse 20 says, "So Ahab sent unto all the children of Israel and gathered the prophets together unto Mount Carmel. And Elijah came unto all the people and said, How long will ye be between two opinions? If the Lord be God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him. And the people answered not a word." And this goes on all the time. I mean, we have proved over and over who Jesus is. But yet and still, there's still halt between two opinions. Some say yes, then some say no. But see, but somewhere along the line, you have to make up your mind. See, we hear a lot of me no more. We can't make up your mind for you. So in other words, how long are you going to be here between two opinions? And see, this goes on all over the world. We have followers and listeners all over this planet. Brazil, Germany, Europe, everywhere. Not just centralized. Oh no, oh no. We got people all over the world that are following a lot of me no more. Now, look what it says here in verse 22, he says, "Then said Elijah unto the people, I, even I only, remain a prophet of the Lord, but Baal prophets are 450. In other words, everybody's falling behind Jesus. But Yah has people all over this world, not in big numbers, like myself, all over this world is saying the same thing that I'm saying. Talking to Israel, warning Israel about Yah's return. Warning Israel about Elijah is coming. Warning Israel about Jesus, a.k.a. Lucifer, Yeshua, whatever you want to call him. There are people just like me, myself, all over this planet warning our people. All right, now that being said, let's go a little further. Let's look at verse 23. It says, let them therefore give two bullocks, and let them choose one bullock for themselves, and cut it into pieces, and lay it on wood, and put no fire under, and I will dress it. And I will dress the other bullock, and lay it upon the wood, and put no fire under it. All right, now what he's saying here is that he's going to let them do a sacrifice, and he's going to do one. All right? Look what it says here. In verse 24, it says, and call ye on the name of your God, and I will call on the name of the Lord. And the God that answers by fire, let him be God. And all the people answered and said, it is well spoken. In other words, okay. We'll go along with that. But now, let's jump on down here. We're going to look at verse 26. It says, and they took a bullock, which was given them, and they dressed it, and called on the name of Baal from morning even unto noon, saying, O Baal, hear us. But there was no voice, nor any that answered. And they leaped upon the altar which was made. All right. Now, look what happened in 27. It says, and it came to pass at noon that Elijah mocked them and said, cry loud, for he is a God. Either he's talking, or he's pursuing, or he is in a journey, or pre-adventure. He sleepeth and must be awakened. So in other words, they ain't getting no answer from their God. But see, Jesus is not a God. I keep saying it over and over. He is not answering any of their prayers. One thing that I don't understand is, how can the white man worship God, and then we being the slave, worship the same God, and all of our prayers get answered? Now, they've been praying over there to get justice ever since Trayvon, and even before Trayvon, you know, there have been many, many blacks that have been killed. We ain't got no answer yet. Ain't got no justice. Know why? Because Jesus is not our God. But we can't see that. Now, let's jump on down here. For time's sake, we're going to jump on down to verse 30. Let's do 36. It says, and it came to pass at the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice that Elijah the prophet came near and said, Lord of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, let it be known this day that thou art God in Israel, and that I am thy servant, and that I have done all these things at thy word. Hear me, O Lord, hear me, that this people may know that thou art the Lord God, and that thou hast turned their hearts back again. Verse 38, he says, then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt offering, and the wood, and the stone, and the dust, and licked up the water that was in the trenches. Okay, here we see God answered Elijah, the prophet. He answered him with fire from heaven. All right. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to jump down here to verse 40. Look what happened. It says, and Elijah said unto them, take the prophets of Baal. Let not one of them escape. And they took them, and Elijah brought them down to the brook of Kishon and slew them there. See, Yah told Elijah to kill all those false prophets. And see, like I said, God doesn't change. And see, these false preachers, prophets, whatever you want to call them here in America, God is going to do the same thing to them again. Now, let's go to Jeremiah. Let's go to Jeremiah, and we're going to prove that. See, because God is a God that uses people to inflict pain on his people, then come back and destroy them. Look at Jeremiah 23. We're going to read verses 1, 2, and 3. All right, and 4, he said, woe unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, said the Lord. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, against the pastors that feed my people, ye have scattered my flock. Look what he said. Now, listen to it closely. He said, ye have scattered my flock and driven them away and have not visited them. Behold, I will visit upon you the evil of your doing, saith the Lord. Now, you heard him say that the pastor did it, right? Now, watch here. Next verse, he says, and I will gather the remnant of my flock out of all the countries, whether who I have driven them. See, Yah will use someone else to inflict pain on his people, then come back and destroy them. Remember what he did for Pharaoh after Pharaoh had left, let my ancestors and your ancestors leave Egypt. And they had a 3-day head start on them. And then Yah came back and told Pharaoh, he's going to go back and get them. And that's why he pursued them. And what happened? Y'all know the story. He killed his whole army. Now, let's go a little further here. He says, verse 3 says, I will gather the remnant of my flock out of all the countries, whether I have driven them, and will bring them again to their fold. And they shall be fruitful and increase. And I will set up shepherds over them, which shall feed them. And they shall fear no more, nor be dismayed, neither shall they be lacking, saith the Lord. Now, Yah says he's going to deal with these pastors over here. He's going to deal with all these pastors all over the world that have led his flock astray, even though he used them to do it, to inflict pain on us, because he had to use somebody to punish us. See, so Yah is going to take care of all these pastors. Oh yeah, the ones hooping and hollering, got 10,000 falling behind them and lying and telling people, making all these promises to them that they're going to do this and they're going to do that, and none of these things ever come to pass. Okay, let's go a little further. Let's go to the book of Ezekiel. Got another one for you here. My brothers and sisters, is right here in the pages. All we got to do is just read it and think about it. Ezekiel, the 14th chapter. Let's look at verses 9, 10, and 11. Look what it says there. He said, and if the prophet be deceived when he has spoken a thing that I, the Lord, what? Deceive that prophet. See, Yah will use a prophet in order to lie to his people and then come right back and kill him for doing it. It's right here in the word. He said, I deceive him. Look what he says here. Then he says here in verse 9, he says, I, the Lord, have deceived that prophet, and I will stretch out my hand upon him and will destroy him from the midst of my people, and they shall bear the punishment of their iniquity. The punishment of the prophet shall be even as the punishment of him that seeketh unto him. Y'all don't play. Israel, y'all need to see this right here. He said, that the house of Israel may go no more astray from me, nor be polluted anymore with all their transgression, but that they may be my people and I may be their God, saith the Lord God. See that? Israel, you have to see it for whatever it is. These pastors that spew not the lies that Lucifer, aka Jesus, have told him to do, and Lucifer knows when the end is going to be. I prove it to you. Let's go to Matthew. Look what he says here in Matthew. Matthew 24 and 14. Look what he says. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a testimony unto all nations. And then shall the end come. He knows that after he do what he say he gonna do, y'all say he gonna bring him down. My Hebrew Israelite brothers and sisters, it's time to see it for what it is. It's time to come back to your God. It's time to wake up. Until next time, my sisters and brothers, shalom.